I'm sure at this point, if you've watched any amount of credit card YouTube, you've heard of a retention offer before. And in that conversation, one lender in particular's name comes up time and time again, that lender being Amex. Amex is the one lender that everybody gets constant retention offers on, partially because their cards do have higher annual fees than a lot of other lenders out there, but also because they're one of the most lenient in giving retention offers out to folks. However, what you might not realize is that you can technically get a retention offer on all the cards you hold, no matter what lender they come from. So in this video, I'm going to explain exactly what a retention offer is and why you'd want one. And then I'll give you some strategies as to how to get retention offers with all the different lenders out there. And then lastly, I'll tell you all about my personal experience last week whenever I asked for a retention offer on my Amex Gold card, even though I was stuck in pop-up jail, at least with the Amex Platinum card. To start though, let's talk about what a retention offer is and why you should care about them. A retention offer is basically just a one-time bonus that a lender will give you in order to help you justify keeping a card open for another year. So yes, technically a retention offer is supposed to be reserved for somebody who is actually looking to cancel one of their cards and is a last-ditch effort from the lender to get you to keep that card by giving you some extra bonus points, statement credits, wiping the annual fee, or what have you. If the lender you're working with is a good lender, then likely they will give you some kind of retention offer because they want to keep you as a customer and they will show you that they value you in that way. Also, while we're at the beginning here, I do want to clear up one common misconception I see where people seem to think that a retention specialist or a human behind the screen is the one that's offering you the retention offer and they make up the offer there on the spot, when in reality this is an algorithm based thing. And even whenever you do get a retention offer, a lot of times that specialist cannot change it at all for you because it's just set by the algorithms. Back to what a retention offer is though, just know that the amount of value that you are offered from a lender completely depends on your credit profile with them and whether or not they think they should extend it to you, on top of things like what card you're actually asking for a retention offer on, like what kind of annual fee it has on it. And obviously there are more factors than just that, but those are some of the main things to keep in mind. But for example, you might see a retention offer out there that will just wipe your $95 annual fee on your card. But if you have a higher tier card, like maybe the Amex Gold or Platinum card, you might get a retention offer that asks you to spend, you know, say $3,000 on the card in 6 months, and they'll give you 30,000 points or something like that. Of course, a lender does not have to give you a retention offer by any means. And we'll talk about all of the lenders here in a little bit and which ones of those are actually going to give you retention offers for the most part. But in my opinion, if you are somebody that's strongly considering either downgrading or canceling a card, then there's really no reason to not ask for one. As we'll talk about in the next section, there are certain ways that you can get retention offers without ever actually wanting to cancel the card. But for now, let's just assume that you are somebody that's looking to get rid of the card that you're currently holding. And on that note, I also want to mention that I am somebody that's of the opinion that you should never just automatically cancel a card before considering if you can downgrade it to a no annual fee product instead. In general, closing a credit card can hurt your credit score because it will lower the total amount of open accounts you have. But more importantly, it's going to affect stuff like your credit utilization ratio and more than that as well. So I think always your first check should be, can I downgrade this card to something that just has no annual fee so that I can leave it open forever? Because in reality, that's kind of the best case scenario, as you want to be able to leave your cards open for as long as you can to help build that credit history, add to your total credit limits and number of accounts opened and everything like that. Also, if you're curious to keep a card active once you do downgrade it to a no annual fee version that might not be giving you any value really, I would personally just put a subscription on those cards, or maybe just put one small charge on them every few months or so, just so you keep those accounts active, because if not, the lenders might actually close your cards for inactivity. Then again, there are a lot of credit cards out there that do not have a good downgrade path, specifically the Amex charge cards, for example. So really your only options to avoid any annual fees on those type of cards is to cancel them. And don't worry, that is not a detrimental thing to do by any means, because as long as your account was in good standing, that credit card account should still age on your credit report for up to 10 years, I believe. And in those 10 years, hopefully you've added a couple other credit cards that have started to age, you know, up to at least 10 years old. And those new cards should help to kind of boost your credit score up over those years, so that whenever that credit history for the oldest card does fall off of your account, it doesn't hurt you as much. Okay, now that we know what a retention offer is, let's talk about the strategies that you can use to get a retention offer with each lender, as well as optimize your chances of getting multiples of them. First of all, I have to say that generally, like I said before, retention offers are only supposed to be used whenever you are looking to cancel a credit card. On top of that, you also only want to really be applying for these right after your annual fee posts on your cards. I know in the past you used to be able to kind of request a retention offer whenever, like mid card member anniversary year, but these days lenders will kind of see that as you trying to game the system a little bit. So it's really only smart to ever do it after your annual fee posts. That way it does kind of look like you're struggling to justify the card for another year. When it comes to the actual strategy for getting a retention offer, the steps are honestly pretty simple. The first thing you want to do is call the card issuer with the card that you're trying to get the retention offer on, and then you just explain why you're thinking of canceling this card. Then you wait for them to see if they can give you an offer or not, and then you either accept or decline the offer that they give you, and really after that, that's all you have to do. But while that does sound really simple, I know this process can be pretty scary for folks, especially if they have to call in and they're not actually looking to cancel the card. So let me go ahead and walk you through what you can kind of expect from each lender before you actually go ahead and call them. And just to keep this video, you know, somewhat short, I'm going to kind of templatize the way that you should be talking to these lenders, because the actual process of you getting a retention offer is going to be basically exactly the same with each lender. But I will break down what you can expect from each of them in terms of whether or not they'll actually give you a retention offer, or what kind of retention offer you might be able to get from them if they do give you one. But let's go ahead and start it off with a lender who's arguably the easiest to get a retention offer from, that being American Express. There are really two main ways to reach Amex's retention department. You can either, one, call up the number on the back of your card and ask to be directed to that retention department, or two, you can actually just use Amex's chat feature, which is what I did in the example I'll be talking about after this. And then at that point, once you get connected and verify your information with them, you basically just want to tell them that your annual fee for blank card just posted to your account, and that you're considering closing the card, but wanted to see if they have any retention offers on your account that they could offer you to maybe help you keep the card open for another year. At this point, the retention specialist is probably going to try to, you know, pitch you on all the benefits that this card has and how you can get value from it without a retention offer. But as you'll see in my example later, I don't really care to hear about that, because this point, we kind of know exactly what's going on with our credit cards. So I kind of brushed that off since I was using the chat feature to do mine. But if you're on the phone with them, you can just hear them out, I guess. And then just reiterate your point from before, where you're still considering canceling the card because you don't think you'll get value from it in this next year, and you want to see if they have a retention offer available to you on your account. And then at that point, they're going to go ahead and check your account to see if they have any preloaded retention offers for you. And then if they do have one on your account, they're going to offer it to you. I should have mentioned this earlier, but before you even get to this point, you should kind of know a number in your head that you'd be willing to accept, especially if you're on the phone with them, because you're not going to have that much time to decide at that point whether you're going to keep or cancel it. Of course, if you get one that you don't really like, you could always ask them to check for another one. But as I talked about earlier, these specialists generally cannot actually change the offer they give you. It just comes to them based on an algorithm. But if you get an offer that you like and you do accept it, at that point, they are going to have you read the legal disclosures that come with that offer. And you basically just want to make sure you tell them that, yes, I want to keep this card open and I will accept the retention offer that you're giving me. If you do deny the retention offer, you want to make sure that you are not going to cancel your card if you don't want to, because in general, like I said, if you deny the retention offer, they're expecting you to just close the card after that. So at that point, you need to make it abundantly clear that, no, I don't want to cancel the card and I don't want the retention offer. I'll just leave it open for another year and see if I can get value from it. Or if neither of those situations apply to you and you want to cancel or downgrade the card, hopefully downgrade the card, then you can just walk through that process with them instead, and they might transfer you to another specialist, but you can just take it from there. For Amex in particular, I found some data points on sites like upgradedpoints.com, where they shared the general offers they've seen come from Amex, and for their charge cards in particular, let's talk about what they've seen. The first offer they listed was for the Amex Gold card, where somebody got an offer of 20,000 points for spending $2,000 in 3 months. For the Amex Green card, the data point showed just 7,500 points with no spending requirement at all. And for the Platinum card, the retention offers varied a lot. The three they listed, though, was one for 50,000 points with no spending requirement, which is kind of crazy. Another one for a $695 statement credit, which would offset the annual fee, of course. And another one for 60,000 points after the person spent $4,000 in 3 months. Now, of course, I'd like to hear y'all's data points, so be sure to leave those in the comments below. But if I do end up getting a retention offer on my gold card later in the video, you'll be able to see what I got compared to what these data points offer. Also note that you can actually get retention offers on their no annual fee cards, as well as their co-branded cards like with Hilton. But I assume that most people are mainly asking for retention offers on the charge card, so I thought I'd share that with y'all. Also, I know that a lot of people try to take advantage of Amex's leniency on giving retention offers and try to request a ton of them. Personally, I think you need to be pretty careful with this, and I kind of fall more into the thought process of Luke from Luke's Points and Miles, where he mentions he only requests retention offers on his Amex cards every other card member anniversary year. And while that still seems pretty frequent in my eyes, it does make a lot more sense than applying for one on every one of your Amex cards every single year. I imagine that Amex does keep track of that information and will use it against you when it comes to future credit card applications with them, so I just wouldn't mess with it. For example, if you only ever use your Amex credit cards for retention offers or welcome offers, then why would they give you another card? And on top of that, only using your cards for those purposes is a one-stop shop to getting yourself thrown in Amex pop-up jail. And with how strict they've been on Amex pop-up jail lately, I don't know about you, but I'm not going to test them. Of course, the easiest method and the way that makes the most sense is to only ever request a retention offer when you're genuinely thinking about downgrading or canceling a card. But if you're somebody that wants to be slightly more aggressive, I'd personally say maybe doing it every other year is going to be a lot safer than doing it every year. I just want you to realize what the consequences could be before you just go requesting them willy-nilly, thinking that no harm will ever be done to you. Now, of course, that was more of an Amex specific section there, but that general process, as I mentioned before, is very similar to what you would do with every single other popular lender out there. But now let's go ahead and talk about what you can expect from the other banks when it comes to what retention offers they do give you, if they give you one at all. With Chase, for example, I'm just going to tell you right now that you have a very low likelihood of getting any kind of retention offer with Chase, so I'd only recommend requesting one if you genuinely do want to cancel your card. Of course, there are going to be people out there that want to play this super aggressively and will still go and request them, you know, just because. But for me personally, I know that Chase already has a bunch of strict rules and I just don't really want to mess with it. So I won't be requesting any retention offers with Chase unless I do genuinely want to cancel or downgrade a card. If you do actually get a retention offer though, it does seem like you don't ever actually have to do any kind of spending requirement for the most part. And they'll usually just give you some kind of statement credit to help offset that annual fee. And it seems just kind of as a last ditch effort from Chase to get you to keep the card for one more year. With Citi though, generally they are going to offer you some kind of amount of bonus points for a certain amount of spend. For example, with the Citi Premier card, we do see that some people get the annual fee waived completely, but a lot of times you might see an offer like 10,000 points for spending $3,000 in 3 months. And in general, I've only really seen data points suggesting that you get retention offers on their annual fee cards, including co-branded cards. With Capital One, while the process is really similar to all the other banks, generally all you'll see from them is either a statement credit or you'll get your annual fee waived. I'm honestly not too sure how frequently Capital One does give retention offers, but considering how annoying they are with a lot of their other processes, I personally would not bank on the fact that I'd get a retention offer with them, but maybe you'll get lucky. I'm not sure. You can also get retention offers from, like I said, basically every other bank out there, like US Bank, Bank of America, Barclays, etc. But every lender will have their own algorithms that determine your eligibility, so your mileage may vary with each of these. Now that we've covered what a retention offer is, why you should care about them, and how you can get them with all the major banks out there, let me share my recent experience in requesting one for myself. For those of y'all that have seen my most recent credit card roadmap video, at least at the time of me recording this, of course, you'll know that I've been considering requesting a retention offer on my Amex Gold card, mainly because I'm sitting at 524 with Chase, so I can't add any more of their cards, and I'm also in pop-up jail with Amex, at least for the Amex Platinum card. But technically, I knew that if I was able to get a retention offer with Amex, I wouldn't have to add a new card to my account, but could be effectively spending towards a bonus still. So once my annual fee posted on my Amex Gold card about a week ago, and just so you know, that was about 2 weeks after my card member anniversary date, for those of y'all that are wondering, but right after I saw that post, I immediately pulled up my Amex app and jumped into their chat feature. Based on what I had heard from the credit community Discord, which is linked below as always, I was thinking I'd get anywhere in the range of 20 to 30,000 points for spending either $2,000 or $3,000 in 6 months. But also, like I said before, I knew my mileage could vary and I really had no idea what offer I'd get. And since I was in Amex pop-up jail, I honestly didn't think I would get any retention offers given to me, because if they're not gonna give me a welcome bonus for a card, why would they give me a retention offer? Just keep that in mind though, as we go through this conversation here that I had with Amex. Okay, so first of all, like I said, the first thing I did was go to my normal home screen of my Amex Gold card, where I could see that the renewal membership fee did post for $250. Then I just clicked on the top right corner of my screen to reach the Amex chat feature. Once I was in there, I basically just chatted with the bot, telling them that I had an annual fee renewal I wanted to talk about. And then I got connected with a representative named Dave here. And he basically had me confirm what card I was talking about with the annual fee. And then he confirmed it was for my Amex Gold card and basically just told me what the actual annual fee was that posted on my card. So then I explained to him that the reason I was reaching out was to actually talk about maybe canceling this card and seeing if there was a retention offer on my account. At that point, he transferred me over to a membership consulting professional who could better assist with my request. And then I got connected with Bruce, who was the retention specialist in this case. He basically just reiterated what I had said before and said that they valued my relationship and everything like that. So obviously I thought he'd be, you know, pretty helpful in this case. Then as you can see here in the middle of the screen, he says, "I also understand that you're looking for a retention offer. However, if you allow, we can check how your card can generate the best value for you permanently." So this is that point where I was talking about earlier that he was gonna, you know, basically just reiterate everything that the card has to offer for me in chat form. And I just didn't really care to see that. So instead of entertaining it, I basically just said, "Yes, that's correct. I'm just looking for a retention offer on my card," and kind of ignored that last, you know, section he sent there. And then he got to work right away on looking for a retention offer for my account. And just a few minutes later, he said that they had an amazing offer for me today. And the offer that they did extend to me was for 30,000 Amex membership rewards points after I spent $3,000 or more on purchases on my Gold card account within 3 months of accepting the offer. And then also they did note that the 30,000 points would be credited to my account 8 to 12 weeks after the purchase requirement has been met. And then he basically just said, "Does that sound good? Are you gonna take it?" And this is where I basically told him, like, well, I mean, the points do kind of fit in line with what I was hoping to get, but is there any way I can extend that spending period out to 6 months instead of 3? I explained to him too that I have a big move coming up and then I wasn't sure how I'd be able to hit the spending requirement, as I told him about before whenever I was actually requesting the retention offer in the first place. And he told me right here that he was sorry, but they do not have the option to change or modify the offer. Once again, reiterating that this is an algorithm-based thing. And then I asked him if I could think about it for a moment, and I was thinking maybe even if I just sat there for like a minute or two, he might, you know, send me a better offer somehow. But after like a minute or so of me waiting, he didn't do that. So I just told him that I'd accept the offer. And then the next section of text he sent was for the legal disclosure for the offer agreement. And I read through this, you know, with a fine tooth comb. Now, this to me was the most interesting part about those legal disclosures. And I'm just going to read it to you. What it says was that purchases may fall outside of the 3-month period in some cases, such as the delay in merchants submitting transactions to us, or if the purchase date differs from the date you made the transaction. If this happens, these purchases will not be counted towards your eligibility for this offer. So to be safe, you obviously want to put your purchases on this earlier rather than later, basically. And then it also says that eligible purchases are purchases for goods and services minus returns and other credits. Eligible purchases do not include fees or interest charges, purchases of traveler's checks, purchases of gift cards, person-to-person payments, or purchases of other cash equivalents. Now, for those of y'all that know Amex, you know that they absolutely hate whenever you buy gift cards with your cards to, you know, kind of manufacture some spend. So I wasn't going to do that anyways, but this is, you know, the first time I think I've really seen them lay it out to me like this. But now you know kind of what to expect whenever you actually get a retention offer. These have to be natural purchases that you would have been putting on the card either way. I'm not going to read the rest of the legal disclosure to y'all, but there is some more interesting information further down. But at the bottom of it, he asks, do I have your approval to process your request to keep your card account open? I said, yes, you do. I confirm I want to keep my gold card account open and accept the offer stated above. And then he just activated the offer for me right there. And that was kind of that. What I did ask him after that, before the conversation ended, was if every purchase from that point on would count towards that retention offer. And he confirmed for me that yes, it would. So theoretically, the purchases that I put on that card that night should have already started counting towards that retention offer. Obviously, I have no good way to really know that until the points do get deposited to my account. So to be safe rather than sorry, you don't want to just, you know, calculate up to exactly $3,000 worth of spend, but put something like $3,500 or $4,000 on this card in those 3 months just to ensure that you're going to get that retention offer. Hopefully now that you've seen that, you have a little bit more confidence in requesting a retention offer for yourself. And if you're interested in hearing more about my personal experience with credit cards at the age of 23 and how I've added 9 cards to my setup to accumulate hundreds of thousands of points so far, be sure to go ahead and watch this video next. As always, Odin and I both want to say thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please consider giving this video a like and subscribing to the channel, and we'll catch you guys next time.